you have any final hints or anything you can say about security breach?
Give it to us, baby.
Get people excited.
Yes.
Even just one word, like a code or anything.
Give me something. Look just like me, huh? Welcome back to the arcade today. Oh, we're about to have a very exciting week ahead. Security Breach 1216 comes out. And my best friend, Dawko. Welcome, everybody. Welcome back to the show. No, Dawko, my best friend. You don't believe me, do you? Roll the footage.
Oh, my
God. Way too loud for that shit.
Oh, my God.
Freddy,
oh, my God. They kept this shit a secret. What the fuck? Fucking bunny or rain for me now.
You will sign a legal disclaimer releasing us of all
I ain't signing shit
that might have happened during your visit. Have an awesome night and we'll see you again soon. Would you like to take a short survey about your experience?
12/16/2021. See?
Told ya.
So he just did an interview with the devs, two of the devs from Steel Wool Studios, about the upcoming Security Breach game that's coming out in just a matter of days. And make sure you watch the entire interview. I'm going to leave a link in the description below if you can check that out if you haven't already. Yes, yeah, so I'm very excited. I'm going to shut up. Don't forget to lick that like button, subscribe to the channel. The holidays are here. Let's get it popping.
And welcome to today's interview.
Hello, everybody.
For such a long time, and I'm so excited.
I love the green screen.
Do this with the wonderful Steelwool, the creators of the upcoming game Security Breach, which is coming next week. Next week.
Oh my God!
2.5 years since it was introduced on Scott's website.
Speaking
really,
of toys,
really excited. I just want to give you guys like a massive round of applause. Don't worry, I'll put in some audio in the atmosphere.
I got some more stuff coming this week. We're going to do a big unboxing before the release of the game.
Be something mind-blowing. Like from seeing the trailers and everything for the past
the trailers. Years,
it looks insane. You guys saw a reaction to it, so yeah, we're all really excited for this. And
he's so excited.
So if you guys want to introduce yourselves, and then we'll get straight into it.
My name is Jason Topolsky. I'm one of the co-founders, co-owners of Steel Wool.
What's up, Jason?
Director, creative director for the studio. And?
And I'm Ray McCaffrey. I'm an executive producer for all things Five Nights here at Steel Wool.
Woo! Awesome. So like I said, the release is coming up very soon.
Yep.
Are you guys excited?
Oh, yeah. Very excited.
I'm excited.
I think it's all of the feelings. I think it's the excitement.
I know you're excited, especially if you're watching this.
Play it soon.
Yeah.
I think it's the combination of all those things. So yeah. Excited to get it in everyone's hands.
Yeah, because the game's been in works for such a long time as well. I think this is like the longest we've been waiting for a FNAF game.
Who's just ran behind Dawko?
So yeah, I think it's actually the longest one. I don't know how long Help Wanted was in the works, but I'm guessing Security Breach took longer to make. So, with that, did you guys face any challenges while making the game?
Oh, I can imagine.
Everybody always runs into challenges with every project.
Yeah.
You know, because which ones are you going to get?
Mm-hmm. I was just telling J-Top here, like, this is my 12th game. And I don't think that there's a single game that shipped that didn't have challenges, and this one certainly had its had its challenges. You know, thinking on it, you know, I've only been at the studio now for about 6 months, and when I joined, it took two full days for the team to take me through the entire Pizzaplex.
Oh my god!
And
it's going to be massive.
This is an indie game studio. We are a small team. This is just a few dozen people.
And a few dozen people.
Like 12 people when we started.
Yeah. And
that's insane.
Is, you know, it is easily
Montgomery
the largest,
Gator.
Most ambitious Five Nights game that's ever been built.
Chica.
Shoestring budget, tiny team.
Oh, man, I'm ready. Get Music Man the hell away from me.
You know, trying to build something as grand as what we're doing with the team size that we have is that is a challenge, but it's a fun one. know, it's it's been a lot of fun bringing this whole thing to fruition. So
with the challenges, do you guys have any like the biggest challenge that you guys had, if you remember any,
or trying to keep like this damn thing a secret
that stands out, or is just a lot?
So to me one of the biggest ones was when we started like, geez, 2.5 years ago. This is like back during Dreadbear.
Yeah.
Right. Is that
who's Dreadbear?
One of our other directors, Evan.
Remember, I'm very new to the series, so
index cards, and we did an overhead view of the whole building, right?
Mm-hmm.
This is what the space is, right? This is what we want. These are all different areas. And then we handed that off to our sets guys, and then they took what was a two-story building and they made a three-story building. And then we were like, we're gonna keep it. We'll just add more stuff. And we, you know, that was one of those moments where it really exploded into a much bigger space.
He got a full drum set. Oh, I need that Foxy.
It's technically more than one story.
Toy behind him.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, I think the I think the biggest challenge is,
by the way,
you know, where do you draw the line on the fun? So it's the job on the producer to be like, we need this because it makes the game so special, but do we really need this because we have other things to do? And so
and you're like, but it would be super cool.
That's how it always starts.
Hear something and I'll go,
oh my god,
that thing. And then by the time it was over, I'm like, I'm gonna go away and find time. I'm gonna go find a way to make this happen because this is
super cool. Yeah.
Dude, when you have an idea about that, something,
one of the arcades was also a dance club. Hey,
I hope so.
Imagine LF FNAF club in that thing.
Revolution in the arcade.
There's like a fakey version of one that's around
the arcade.
It's like a fakey one.
Well, imagine that shit.
Okay, I think I was going to add on to that. Yeah, I was going to mention the game. I think people found that the game was going to be like over 70 gigabytes, which pretty
70
much
gigs,
how
bro.
Big the game is going to be
70 gigs. You know how big that is? That's like Call of Duty size.
There's two parts to it.
Holy,
it is huge.
He's a disc,
absolutely massive. And then the second thing is, like,
imagine being on disc.
We have some optimizations that we've got to do, and so we're gonna try and bring that down. I don't think that's gonna happen for launch, but as time goes on, we're gonna try and bring that down. Work on adjusted compression settings, things like that, to make people's lives a little bit easier. But when a game is as big as this one, you really have to do that sort of thing very carefully.
Yeah. Did any of the older FNAF games like inspire Security Breach at all? Anything like that?
Every single one. Oh, absolutely. I mean,
I figured it was all like connected and shit.
It's so rich.
Yeah.
There's so much stuff that you want to, that you just want to play with. And it's really hard to even hit everything you want to.
Yeah.
You know, it's like all the characters, all the locations, you know, just like the time periods, you know, it's like, there's so much that you want to hit and that you want to honor and you want to use that you can't get all of it.
Yeah.
So,
yeah, you added Music Man back though.
Yeah.
Yeah. So who's Music Man?
Surprise, by the way.
Like, where's he originally from? The OGs is watching this. Like, when did he first debut? What's his story about Music Man?
Oh, everybody around the studio is yelling his little catchphrase now, which is kind of funny. You know, the
what's the catchphrase?
Like, Music Man. Like, yeah, that was cracking us up. But you know, it's technically not Music Man.
Okay. Right.
Music Man will not be making an appearance. DJ Music Man, however.
Well, that goes back to what they were saying about having the club. DJ Music Man could be in the club inside the pizzeria.
Do you have a favorite character animatronic in Security Breach?
Yeah. I was like, it's funny. Do you want to do this one right first?
Ooh.
Yeah, I mean, I joining the team, I just feel like I got super close to Freddy. And so I'm just sort of like, I'm a huge Freddy.
So Freddy's a good guy in this one, actually, right? That's the one that Gregory's like us going to be inside.
Makes it so hard. Is that they evolve as the night goes on, and there's some that are uncomfortably
those are ones that I want right there.
Ended up being my favorite, so
I was like, for the whole series, definitely Helpy is my favorite, period. Like, yeah. I will try to work Helpy into everything. Helpy is like my favorite bot, period. I used to have it on a keychain. Like, Scott sent us some merch really early on when we were working with him. And I had this little Helpy keychain, and I just drove it into the ground. You know, it's like it was just his head and part of his face mixed up, you know, meshed up.
Oh, that sounds sick.
Exactly what he should have been. But in Security Breach, Sun Moon, the our daycare attendant.
Yeah.
Sun Moon's creepy as shit.
My favorite, by far.
Yeah. Like, I think that's a lot of people's favorites as well, especially the voice of Moondrop. Is it Moondrop?
It's the daycare attendant.
There you go.
Okay.
You know,
we'll just say that then. No reveals.
Dig more.
Kellen. Yeah, Kellen announced it. So that was really cool.
Those were really fun sessions.
It was. I think it was after a Freddy session. We were talking about who we needed for Sun and Moon, and after one of the Freddy sessions, J-Top comes to me and goes, "Let's have Kellen. Let's get Kellen." Sun and Moon. And it was like, "Oh, yeah, let's do it." And then the first time I heard it, I was just like, "Oh, great! So now this thing is going to be even more terrifying than it was yesterday."
So you said your favorite character was Helpy. Right.
Oh yeah.
You know what I'm gonna ask? Have you heard about Buff Helpy?
Oh yeah.
I think I saw a meme about that on Reddit.
Is Buff Helpy gonna be in Security Breach?
No chance.
I cannot confirm or deny.
Oh god, I'm only joking. So
you'll see some Helpy. You'll see some Helpy.
That's good, because Helpy is one of my favorites as well.
Yeah,
that make me happy. Okay, so we talked about characters.
We talked about characters.
Characters that we have not seen yet.
That's right, baby. Yeah. If you're watching this right now, debut tomorrow.
Amazing.
Glam Rock Froggy. Yeah. Exclusive.
It looks like there's going to be, from the trailer and everything, everybody thought that there's a big 80s vibe within the mall.
80s vibe within the mall.
It being like very 80s themed at all, or just a choice?
You know, it's funny. It's just a little bit. I mean,
it's always a reason.
Because of my age.
Mm-hmm.
I was one of those kids that in the 80s, when, you know, the original Chuck E. Cheese's opened,
yeah,
this is up in Tacoma, Washington.
The original Chuck E. Cheese.
My soccer team, like, you know, grade school soccer team, every single party we had was at Chuck E. Cheese. It was this cool two-story one. I was telling Scott about it, you know. Oh, it was really neat.
Quick story, by the way. I just went to Chuck E. Cheese about an hour ago because I'm trying to figure out a location for me to film, like, my opening skit for Security Breach this week. So I walk in. This literally just happened like an hour ago. I walk in, I have like all my FNAF shit on that I have on right now. And the plan is I'm just going to go, hey, you know, I'm a YouTuber. I want to use this location just to record something for my YouTube about a game that's coming out that's similar to Chuck E. Cheese. That's kind of going to be my pitch. But in my mind, this person was going to be like a super FNAF fan. And they was going to be like, oh my God, this is great. I watched the arcade too. I sub to your channel. Like, that's in my mind. Anyway, in reality, this is what happened. Mind you, I'm in New Orleans. It's a little crazy. I walked in, you know, kids running around, walking the door, some little kid. Hey, Missa, you got a quarter? I was like, oh, yeah, sure, kid. Gave him a quarter, actually a quarter or two. Then I finally got to the front desk. It's this girl, and she just go, Hey, welcome to Chuck E. Cheese. Or whatever she said. I said, hey, you know, I just went through the whole spiel. And she goes, 5 nights what? We close at 9, sir.
I think it's awesome. FNAF anyway. The big neon vibes and everything. So
neon here's an is lit.
Question. Does the game? From the trailer and everything, it seems to hint that the game
get in there.
Takes place in just one night. Can you confirm that or talk about that a bit more, or deny it, or not answer it?
There are two ways to go, right? You can make it a 5 nights in the one location, right? And this was something that we worked on early on, story-wise. You know, we were talking with Scott about. And you take the player out, and then you come back, and then, like, you know, maybe instead of 5 nights, it's more of like one night, and each hour is kind of like a major beat.
Yeah.
Right.
Like,
so it gets harder each hour.
Your big 5 nights, right? Mm.
Yeah.
So that's where we went with it, which I think works out really, really fantastic.
Yeah. I mean, I think a lot of people thought that anyway, because like in the description and stuff, you say like you have to survive the night. I think it was pretty obvious anyway, but just wanted to ask anyway.
Clear
it up.
Ask
anyway. It's
more than 5 hours.
Yes.
Okay. Sure. What is your favorite location in the mall? If you have one.
In the mall.
It's just everything. The whole mall.
Mine is
the arcade.
Parts and service. Attached to a very specific warehouse. That is, I cannot wait for people to play in those areas of the game. They are easily my favorite.
Yeah, that hour.
It must be some scary shit in there.
A lot of people agree with us, with what Ray's saying. There's a certain warehouse down there that a lot of people
I'm getting so excited, honestly.
That's the one that's going to terrify everybody.
Okay.
Gator golf?
Yeah.
Man, if I could go play indoor putt-putt at Gator Golf, I would be very happy.
Dude, what if we did like a skit and like the glow-in-the-dark putt-putt?
Golf and the bowling and stuff. Do those things?
Some things, yes. There are some things that have minigames attached.
Awesome.
That's lit.
You can't like walk into golf and play golf with what's sitting there. You know, you're going to get killed.
Yeah. What's there then, Jason?
But there are stand-up arcades that give you some game elements at times.
Awesome. Yeah.
You know, and for golf, one of the ideas there was like, well, do you want to play a putt-putt golf game there in that room? Or would you rather play like a heightened fantasy version of what a putt-putt golf course would be, you know, where you are down at the height of the ball and you know you're seeing sets from older games and we can do whatever we want, you know?
Oh, that's awesome.
What? So,
in the game,
it's trippy.
Will we, as Gregory, be able to make choices or decisions that change things later on?
The answer is yes.
Like choose your own adventure type thing.
There are choices that you will make and paths that you can take. And then
that's cool.
There are, depending on what choices you want to make and how well you play the game.
Yeah.
You'll have multiple options in the end.
So that means you can watch multiple gamers play this game and get a different outcome, perhaps?
Choices could be there's an hour where, hey, there are two things that you could do, but you don't have enough time. Mm-hmm. You're going to go upstairs or you're going to go downstairs.
Yeah. Oh,
and you have a branching choice at that moment.
That's also really good as well because of replayability. So
exactly.
It's going to be a lot of replay.
And whenever he gets early access and all the other big guys, I don't have to get discouraged because you've already saw the gameplay.
It's, it's funny because that matters a lot to some of us, like our lead designer, Brian Fairmouth in the game. He and I had worked at Telltale Games before.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's like giving people meaningful choices and branches. And, you know, that's always great.
Yeah, and sometimes making the wrong choice that leads to consequences and stuff. I just want to say as well, thank you. Because a couple of months ago, we did the charity stream for St. Jude, and you guys provided a lot of things. And you donated as well. Thank you again. You guys are amazing. It really means a lot to me.
You guys are amazing.
Thank you for doing it. I mean, it's so great that you're doing these regularly and getting so many people involved. And you know, we've been watching you do it before we ever got involved with you. But, you know,
it's fantastic. That's cool. That's so dope.
It really is.
I'm gonna go red now. I'm blushing. So
me too.
You provided some more interesting posters.
Don't laugh at that.
And it's got a lot of people excited and
those posters are incredible.
What's the deal with the Fredbear's Family Diner posters?
It existed.
Okay.
At some point in history.
Yeah.
Right? Oh, you're being cryptic.
I would like to know more.
100%.
I would love to know more.
That's fine. Question mark. Okay, there we go.
Well, imagine the ball mice. The ball mice would be crazy.
The animatronics, you will have some choices.
Yeah.
Well, they're choosing their words so precisely.
Like, you can choose to take.
Yeah.
Spit it out, dude.
But each one's unique, which is really cool. That was something that's
Yeah, I'm really
Look at Jason's face. He's like, yeah, I'm about to get you, bastards.
Yeah.
You try, you know, we're doing everything we can to honor
this. Oh, my cheeks are smiling so much.
At times.
Pause.
You were fuckers. In a room, in an office, closing doors, and, you know.
Yeah, I think we got that from the trailer.
Roxy, whoever trying to get
we got that from the trailer. Yeah.
Other times, you're stuck as Gregory in a place with one of those bots.
Yeah, yeah.
And there's nowhere to hide.
Any plans in the future for multiplayer? Have you guys ever thought
that? Ooh, that'd be lit.
I mean, certainly thought about it. We've talked about it, but nothing concrete right now. Mm-hmm. But it certainly, I mean, as game developers and having made multiplayer games in the past, like, we talk about it all the time.
I think they would make the game even bigger.
And, you know, just kind of go back to one of the earlier things I said, like, that is an undertaking. That is an undertaking. And again, we are an indie studio. We've built an indie game.
The fact that there's still an indie studio at this point is just crazy.
To this point, honors the series. And is a fun, fluid experience. It's complicated. So we talk about it every once in a while. There's nothing, no concrete plans.
I'll throw one thing in there though. Just
give
for
it to
fun,
me.
And because
give
I
it to me.
You, and I think this will be a lot of fun. Is that when we were working on Help Wanted, we actually did a couch co-op multiplayer mode that never got
couch co-op.
It never made it.
Yeah.
But we were playing with it. One person is sitting in the middle of the room and all the other player, and they've got the headset on, and all the other players are in controllers, but they've got the bots and they're trying to jump scare the player that's, you know, trying to protect themselves in the office.
Oh,
that'd be fantastic.
Lit.
Yeah, I remember talking about that ages ago because somebody found it in the files or something.
Oh, of course they did.
Yeah. I think it was it called Flashlight Freeze?
Yeah, it probably was.
Yeah. Remember talking about that, and everybody was like, "Oh my god, we might be getting multiplayer in the future."
It's
crazy.
We even had a character select screen that was like, it was kind of like Gauntlet with like the four, you know, player strips.
Yeah.
And it had like the curtains, so it was kind of like Super Mario 2.
Yeah.
So, the screen.
Pretty sweet.
It's awesome. Well, there you go, guys.
Do want to bring that one back?
Here's an interesting one as well.
Okay.
Are we able to just take a break from being chased by creepy animatronics and just have fun and enjoy ourselves in the mall?
You know, really,
we're here to have
like
fun.
These mini games, these arcades.
Yeah.
Yeah, those do lock you into the game. So you can play the game comfortably and not worry about, you know,
not worry
getting
about
stuck up on.
Yeah. Will
That's
we
cool.
ever get DLC for Security Breach?
That is something that we're talking about right now. So we're starting to make some plans.
Talk about replayability. Holy crap.
A lot of ideas. We're collaborating with Scott on it. There's you know, Dreadbear in particular had such a positive response.
Yes. That was amazing.
We would be silly not to keep people more of Security Breach. So yeah, we're laying down plans right now. More information will start coming out probably next year.
Awesome.
Looks like it's going to be a nice
meantime,
long,
you know, we're gonna be,
stretch to play this game.
We're going to be, you know, patching the game. We're going to continue to do things like quality of life improvements and performance improvements and things like that. So
that's all I can ever ask from a Dale's team.
Things that we want to change that we didn't get to, little things here and there. So you'll see that stuff in the next few months. Just upgrades, updates.
Mm-hmm. That's cool. Stuff.
Then DLC after that.
Yeah, that's amazing. Will there be any Easter eggs in Security Breach?
It's funny, we have so we got, you know, because of the deep lore and because of the history, there's a whole bunch of stuff that we were able to do that was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
I don't know, do you want to talk about some of the stuff that we got? J-Top, you want me to?
Oh,
now we come to Easter eggs, because I'm not an OG.
So as we're building the game,
I'm probably going to miss a lot. I'm going to shut up. Oh, what do you say?
Put this stuff in the game, and I look at it all. Examine it as a producer would do, and I say, I have no idea what any of this means. And he goes, yeah, put it in the game.
That's what OGs.
I know.
I promise you, I'm going to miss so many Easter eggs.
So, like, on top of
y'all are going to be screaming at me.
We've got a bunch of stuff. It's all really, it's really, really interesting stuff. And so, yeah.
I like the fact that Scott is still involved as well, too.
Oh, yeah. I say one thing that you've already called out, like in videos, you know, so far is noticing the arcane skins in the background. Yes. Yeah. There are a lot.
There's a lot.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Every time they say the arcade, I just get so happy.
Scott and his, he's got a team of artists, right? And so they did all sorts of great Easter egg stuff. Like, it's fantastic.
Yeah.
And then there's a bunch of, like, when we were going, well, we have to do a whole bunch of skins. Hey, everybody in the studio, just come up with stuff.
Yeah.
And we made ridiculous arcades. There's some silly ones.
So everything you guys
like during the DLC, the skin's probably going to get crazy
big. So let's say if I was doing a let's play, how long is it going to take me to do everything? Everything.
Well, man, I was trying. So last night, I was trying to do a comprehensive playthrough.
Mm-hmm.
Where I got every single collectible. And I started at 9 and it was like 1:30 in the morning and I was like, okay, I messed up now. You know, I was still like, I was not even near the end. And I was like, man, I just haven't found everything yet. I'm trying to remember where I put some stuff.
You know? He made the damn game.
It's beating everything. Saying how long it takes to beat everything in the game is a complicated question.
Yeah.
To beat everything? Like, I don't want to beat everything. I just want to beat the main game first.
It's going to take a long time, not just because of the size of the pizza books, but also because, like, it's a FNAF game. It is a challenging point where it's like, you really want to go for it?
Oh shit!
There's gonna be some hard moments while playing. Yeah. Am I gonna rage?
Oh yeah.
No, no.
Oh god.
I mean, I hope
so. 70 gigabytes.
Is it gonna be as hard as the freaking baby plushies in our haunted?
No, it's not that hard.
There's no plush babies.
Okay. The thing is, with plush babies now, I can do it first try now. But at the start, it was freaking, really difficult. Out of all of the
makes me nervous.
In Security Breach,
I'm so bad at puzzles.
Which one would you say is your favorite if you could pick?
I mean, I think DJ Music Man is, the most impressive
model creepy.
In the game.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But, you know.
You're reminding me of Choo Choo Charlie, by the way.
Daycare Attendant that's my favorite, but... Man, yeah, DJ Music Man.
Okay, we're coming up to the final questions, but I'll ask one more about the game itself. Is the game going to have subtitles when it releases?
Yeah.
Straightforward.
W.
Nice. Yep.
Good.
Awesome.
For the viewers, we need subtitles.
10, how excited are you guys to get this game into the hands of the fans?
And excited. 11 and a half terrified.
Oh no, don't be nervous.
Imagine it comes out and it's just a dud.
Yeah, it's gonna be nerve wracking.
It's never not been nerve wracking.
Oh my god, look how good this game looks right now. I wonder if we're gonna get a launch trailer.
Yeah, it's like I've always had this sickness from working in film, for working at Telltale. Is just like sitting there and doing reload, and just see comments, see reviews,
The art in Security Breach is amazing. So, oh my god, the Steam poster that was shown.
That Steam poster was lit.
It's insane.
Steam poster was lit.
Scenes, from the trailer and the art.
From the trailer.
And the promotional art, the cartoons, everything. The art has been insane. So people have asked, in the future ever, do you think you guys will ever release like a behind the scenes, like Security Breach art book or anything like that?
We've not talked about an art book, but one thing we have
like a steelbook series,
kind of like some dev diaries. So
that'd be dope.
Having videos I'm in on that. With our game design director.
If they have a hard copy.
Our sets team and one of our art directors and Just getting all those folks out in front of everyone so they can talk a little bit about, you know, how we were all able to, you know, bring their vision of what that world should look like to life. So we're talking about doing that right now, actually.
Awesome. You guys have freaking really pushed FNAF, like, you know, the audience with this
game. Audience.
Like, I remember seeing on the PlayStation YouTube channel how many people watch those trailers and how many people outside of FNAF like came back to it after like years and been like, you know what, like this is looking like the biggest FNAF game ever. I am interested in playing it now. And it, you know, for it's coming out on consoles as well and stuff. Crazy. So I just want to say again,
I'm not sure if I'm gonna play it on console or PC.
The hard work that you're doing, like with Scott as well. Massive thank you to Scott for getting you guys involved with the game and being like, you know what, I'm gonna take a step back and let a studio make their own game. I feel like that was definitely the right decision. So thank you, Scott, and thank you, you guys. Yeah. Honestly, I feel like it's took FNAF to a new level. It really has, and you know, I don't know where FNAF would be right now without you guys, honestly. You've done a really good job. We've Help Wanted as well. I still think Help Wanted to me is like one of my favorite ever. Yeah, thank you for keeping going with FNAF. And like, I was thinking about it the other week in bed. I was like, I don't know, when is FNAF going to end? Like, when is it going to end?
It's never going to end. Never going to end.
Right after Star Wars does.
Right.
Star Wars ain't going nowhere.
It's been so many people. It's had such a huge start. And look, and the, you know, it's just picking up more fans.
Yeah, 100%.
More people on board.
Then this last year, I've so became nice. A FNAF maniac.
Like totally spot on. An enormous thank you to Scott. Like, that's, like, collaborating with him has been an incredible experience from my perspective. Like, it just super, super into our ideas. Gives us amazing ideas to run with, like really helps put fuel in the tank. It's been a really good working experience, honestly.
Oh, that's good.
And then at the end of the day, like, thank you so much for the kind words, but thank you and thanks to all the fans, because if it wasn't for y'all,
you're welcome.
We wouldn't be able to do the thing that we love to do.
You're welcome.
More than anything else. Like, you get into this industry because you have a passion for it.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
You do this job because you've got a Steam library of 200 games and you've only made, you know, 3/4 of the way through it.
Yeah.
Hey, that is the absolute truth. I have so many games I haven't even touched. Oh my God.
We all feel every day with the things we love. Being able to
get it. I love it. Love it.
Is immensely rewarding. So
we're going to wrap it up, guys. And I'm going to give you guys one more question. So the final thoughts of Security Breach. Almost a week to go. Do you have any final hints or anything you can say about Security Breach?
Give it to us, baby.
Get people excited.
Yes.
Even just one word, like a code or anything.
Give me something.
Schematics.
Mm. Okay, so pizza flavor.
What was my pen?
A bit of a difference there. Pizza flavored cotton candy and schematics.
Schematics.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, I remember that.
But yeah, thank you guys so much for today's interview.
All right, listen, we're going to stop it there. If you watched this far into it, you are a FNAF psychopath like me, and we're excited about Security Breach. I will leave the link in the description below for the full Dawko interview. It's about 50 minutes. I'm not sure how much I'm going to edit this down. I just wanted to hear some of the main questions that he had, some questions that I had as well. So, yeah, we're getting real close. So later this week, I will catch y'all in the pizzeria. Better be ready.